how do you assess the situation of media freedom in the region, Dr. Ning?
Particularly in the Southeast Asia region, and certainly due to COVID as well, we noticed that first of all, the media freedom is threatened by economic pressure, which is already not in a good shape since the past 10 years, where a lot of advertising revenue has gone to the tech giants. But of course, this situation has been exacerbated by COVID-19 pandemic with further drop in advertising revenue. And the second itself is the safety issue of journalists. Journalists still needs to go to places to cover, to talk to people, and not everything can be done from home. And this caused a certain amount of danger physically to journalists. And this is in addition to all the physical intimidations, harassments, threats, raids conducted by states and certainly other non-state actors as well. So in addition to all of the problems that journalists face, now we have a health hazard as well. And of course, this is not just in Southeast Asia, throughout the world. I think the Press Emblem campaign has noticed that more than 1,000 journalists have died due to COVID-related illness. And this may or may not be a part of the work, but it is important to note. Thankfully, in some countries, journalists are considered as frontliners, and they are giving priority in terms of vaccination. Just last month, Indonesia has started vaccinated journalists by the thousands. And yesterday, the Malaysian government announced that journalists will also be pushed forward for vaccination as well. So that is certainly a good sign. And third, and speakers have already alluded to this, is the fact that national authorities and governments are using COVID-19 as a pretext to limit freedom of expression and limit access to information and even access to people's movement. So all of this are not really in line with international standards. As a short reminder to everyone and governments alike, that any sort of restrictions, including the use of emergency powers that restricts human rights, including freedom of expressions and freedom of opinion, must be must go through the same as any other sort of test. We call it the three-part test, of course. It must be legitimate. It must be for a purpose and appropriate. And it must be, of course, within the legal framework, the laws. And in terms of emergency, it really must have a very strong purpose. And it must have a sunset clause. It must have a fixed period of time when it will be lifted. And that is certainly something that UNESCO's and of course, and OSCHR have already mentioned. And these are the things that governments are encouraged to really follow the established guidelines set up by international organizations, as well as international standards, to really respect the limitation and when and where those limitations can be met, put in place. So these are some observations regarding media freedom in the region at the moment right now.